We can add multiple levels to our games to make them much cooler. To make it easy to see that I'm in a different level, I'll make different backdrops for my stage. Click on Stage, then Backdrops, and I'm going to make three different stages. The first one, I'll color all orange. The second one, I'll color all yellow. And the third one, I'll color all green. And I'll name these Level 1, Level 2, and Level 3. Now I can go back to my scripts. Here I'm clicked on the stage, so I can write scripts for the stage. And I'll make a way to be able to switch between my backdrops. When the flag is clicked, I'll switch to Level 1. Then I'll wait to receive a message that says Level 2 should start. Switch to Level 2. When I receive the message switch to Level 2, I'll switch to the Level 2 backdrop. And lastly, when I receive the message switch to Level 3, I'll switch to the Level 3 backdrop. Okay. Next, I'll add a new sprite to my project, which will be a door. I'll use a door to switch between levels. I'll click on the Paint New Sprite button. I'll go back to the scripts now. I'll move my door to the right. Now I'll click on the cat to add scripts for it to be able to walk from the left side of the screen to the right side of the screen. Looks good. Now I'll set up a script to have it change levels. When the green flag is clicked, I'll move the cat over to the left side of the screen, say about here. Then I'll wait until the cat touches the door. I'll rename Sprite 2 Door. And now I can say wait until touching door. Once I touch door, I want to switch to the next level. So I can broadcast a message to say that we're switching to the next level. When I start the next level, I want to have the cat move back to the left. So I'll get a motions block and move him back to the left. Then again, I can wait until he touches the door, and then I'll broadcast a switch to level 3. I can duplicate those blocks because I already have those. So now the cat starts on the left, then he waits until he's touching the door, and then once that happens, we broadcast switch to level 2. Then we'll go to x is negative 200, y is 0, and we'll wait until he's touching the door again. Once he's touching the door, he'll broadcast, oops, this is a bug, switch to level 3. Let's look back at the scripts for the stage to see how that will change the backdrops. Here, when the green flag is clicked, I'll switch to level 1. When I receive switch to level 2, I'll switch to backdrop level 2. When I receive switch to level 3, I'll switch to backdrop level 3. I'll click on the cat again, and then we can try and run this script. I click on the green flag, and it should switch to the orange level, because that's level 1. I can move the character to the right, and when he touches the door, he should move back to the left, and the background should change to switch to level 2. Let's see. It worked. This second go to x minus 200, y 0 has happened, and so we're just waiting until he touches the door again, and when he does, we'll broadcast switch to level 3, and if we look at the stage, that will switch the backdrop to level 3, which is green. Let's touch the door again. And it switched to the next level. I have a bug here, though. I didn't move him back to the beginning. Let me fix that. Let me try the whole thing over again. So there we switched to level 2. Here we waited until he touched the door again, then switched to level 3. And then here we are on the final level, which is level 3.